Thank you for joining me today. We've got quite a discussion on our hands about Meghan and Harry. There's been a lot of talk lately about whether their affection for each other is genuine or just for the cameras. Plus, there's buzz about Meghan claiming a 43% Nigerian heritage. Let's dive into it. Starting with Harry and Meghan, they often appear as the picture-perfect couple, especially at high-profile events like the Invictus Games. However, it's worth noting that these public displays of affection aren't as common as you might think. For instance, they reportedly spent a significant amount of time apart following an incident in New York involving the paparazzi. Their careers have also seen some setbacks. Spotify and Netflix have scaled back on their collaborations with the couple, with Netflix even canceling some of their projects. Amidst this, Meghan is trying to carve out a niche as a global lifestyle influencer, but her criticism of the royal family in a Netflix documentary has dented her popularity. So, what do you think about all this? I turn to your comments for insight. ET2 commented, "The Hargles are more than a big show, they are an absolute spectacle." This sentiment seems to resonate with many, as comments like "obscene spectacle" from a 74-year-old user and "grotesque" from Firefly indicate a general agreement. Then there's the issue of Meghan's relationship with her father. Linda pointed out, "Anyone who can blank a loving father off so quickly and coldly is not a kind and loving person." She emphasized how Meghan's father appeared to provide more for her materially compared to his other children. Continuing our discussion, let's talk about Meghan turning her back on her father. Many of you pointed out how this reflects on her character. Linda's words were quite striking. "Turning her back on her dad, especially when he's in poor health, just shows how heartless and cruel she can be." She raises a valid concern about how Meghan's behavior might affect her children. And then there's the drama of their public image. Carol described it as a huge catastrophe on a world stage, while Florence labeled it a big show that's all about Meghan. The sentiment that their love seems more for show than genuine is a common thread in your comments. User VQ7 even suggested that a truly in-love couple wouldn't need external aids to be happy. The comments get even more colorful. Jane says, "It's a big show, big romance. Mimi is smitten with herself." Laura and Angie chime in, describing the pair as sickening and experts at making fools of themselves. Douglas and Wildflowers shared similar views, doubting the genuineness of Meghan's feelings for Harry. Douglas opined, "He might be smitten, but for her, it's all about the money and jewelry." Wildflowers also called them grifters, suggesting Meghan is using Harry. M583's comment added another layer, questioning Meghan's ability to love, describing her as a narcissist who only loves herself. This brings up an intriguing question about Meghan's self-perception and how it influences her actions. Delving deeper into the discussion, many of you, like Nancy, have labeled the couple's affection as a fake show. Patricia and Petteribin echoed this sentiment, emphasizing the theatrical nature of their public displays. Pamela humorously described their antics as showing now at the loony bin, though hoping such drama doesn't influence those who are genuinely struggling. And Acton's comment brought a new perspective. She thinks Harry might be afraid of admitting a mistake, suggesting he's staying in the relationship to avoid the "I told you so" from the world. She advises Harry to seek his own happiness, even if it means leaving Meghan. This resonates with many, as Wendy and Julie agree, calling it words of wisdom. Snow River brought up Harry's past relationships, suggesting he stays with Meghan because she was the only one willing to be with him. Christina urges Harry to be truthful, especially about his children, believing it would bring him peace and maintain his true friendships. Gail's comment paints a stark picture, describing Meghan as a she-devil and questioning her ability to genuinely care. This echoes the earlier sentiment about Meghan's narcissism masking deeper self-loathing issues. All these perspectives paint a complex picture of the couple's public image and personal dynamics. Continuing our lively discussion, Paula shared her thoughts, "It's a big show." Harry may have been enamored with Meghan initially, but now it's all about attention and money for her. This ties back to the idea that Meghan's love for herself might be questionable, as true self-love often manifests in kindness towards others, which some feel Meghan lacks. Renee humorously noted that the couple seems to be fading out into the twilight zone, a sentiment many might wish were literal given their constant presence in the media. Barbara and Susan are also in agreement that the couple's love doesn't seem genuine. Apple's Orange brought up an interesting point about the couple's potential split, predicting a blame game over the legitimacy of their children's birth and royal status. This echoes the sentiment that their breakup, if it happens, will be dramatic. Snowy's mom described the entire relationship as one big show from day one, suggesting Meghan's enjoying the role of a lifetime. Kamal and Nathan's comment adds another layer, comparing Meghan's public displays of affection to those of Princess Catherine, noting Meghan's history of multiple relationships. They also touched on the complex dynamics between Harry, Meghan, and the royal family. They questioned whether Harry can expect his family to welcome Meghan back and apologize after all the public criticism they've faced. This raises a poignant question about the future relationship between Harry, Meghan, and the royal family. Delving into the topic of apologies, the discussion takes an interesting turn. Many of you, like Wildflowers and Joy Smith, question who really owes an apology in this royal saga. Rusty Spence brings up accusations against Meghan, like stealing jewels and fabricating her children's birth, suggesting she and Harry have much to apologize for. Deborah's comment adds a different angle, asserting that Harry should apologize to his family for marrying Meghan. This comment sparked a bit of confusion, leading to a call for clarification from Joy Smith on her stance. The consensus among many of you, including Cassina, MSC, and Jean D'Souza, is that Harry and Meghan's relationship is more of a show than genuine love. Cassina expresses fatigue with their antics, urging them to grow up. MSC succinctly labels it a big show, while Jean D'Souza observes that they are the main stars of their own drama, yet their popularity is waning. Mads's comment paints a grim picture for Harry's future, predicting he will realize he's been used and highlighting his lack of talents. This sentiment is echoed by Lori, Diane, and Wendy, all agreeing that the relationship seems more performative than authentic. Wendy adds a twist, suggesting Meghan is only truly in love with herself. The conversation steers towards the relationship between Meghan and Princess Eugenie. Many of you, like MM583, believe Eugenie is aware of Meghan's perceived phoniness but tolerates it due to her bond with Harry. However, there's a general feeling that this tolerance won't last long. Arlene and Blondie Lee are in agreement that it's all a show, with Blondie Lee nicknaming Meghan the Me Again woman and hinting at an impending conclusion to this drama. Charlie and James Patterson discuss the couple's public image, with Charlie calling them two big losers, emphasizing their focus on PR over genuine character. Liz Simmons and Varen Thomas express indifference and cynicism towards the couple's love life, implying it's all about monetary gain. Janet's humorous take describes Meghan as a narc in her ginger handbag, reflecting a general sentiment of skepticism about the couple's sincerity. Alice and Annette share a similar view, questioning Meghan's fidelity and the authenticity of their relationship. Marcus and Mary add to this, with Marcus expressing discomfort at even contemplating their relationship, and Mary simply stating, "Who cares?" Christina bluntly asserts there's no love between Harry and Meghan, comparing their story to trashy literature. Kaz calls it the biggest show on earth, while Dorothy pleads to leave them alone. Annette counters, describing their public persona as nasty. The discussion wraps up with a response to Dorothy's plea for privacy. The general consensus is that while many would prefer to ignore the couple, their constant media presence makes it challenging. This reflects a fatigue with the ongoing saga and a desire for less public exposure from Harry and Meghan. Continuing our conversation, let's delve into Meghan's recent revelation of having 43% Nigerian DNA and its intriguing timing. Many of you are skeptical, noting the coincidence with a Nigerian guest on her podcast and the debut of Nigerian athletes at the Invictus Games. It seems to some that Meghan is keen on aligning her identity with advantageous narratives for PR purposes. The discussion shifts to Harry's realization of what some call Meghan's manipulative tactics. Jay Jane commented, "Reflecting on the power of imagery, the picture speaks for itself." Carmelita and Suzanne Bruni echoed this sentiment, with Suzanne specifically noting Harry's choice to publicly criticize his family and hoping for swift justice. User BM7 brought up an interesting point about the changing nature of PR strategies in the digital age. They noted that unlike before, when news could disappear, the internet has made it so that bad publicity lingers and constantly reminds people of past incidents. This comment sparked a realization about how the digital world has altered the public's memory and the impact of news stories. As the conversation unfolds, it's clear that there's a growing fatigue with the couple's public antics and a desire for more authentic narratives. The general consensus seems to be a call for change, both in the way Harry and Meghan present themselves and in the public's reception of celebrity news. Exploring the changes in news consumption, Mia Mini and Anjani highlight how the digital age has transformed the public's access to information. Anjani notes, "Thanks to social media, nothing goes away," reflecting the permanence of digital records. The conversation then shifts to the idea of a comedy show featuring Meghan and Harry. While Wonder Woman suggests it could be entertaining, another user, Look Into the Light, expresses doubts, fearing such a show might leave viewers feeling negative emotions. This sparks a debate about the potential tone of a hypothetical show based on their lives. Carmelita Jones and Paula bring a critical perspective, with Paula remarking, "Everything these two do is fishy and only to benefit themselves." This view is echoed by B. Smith, indicating a shared skepticism about the couple's motives. The discussion about Harry's awareness of his situation is also interesting. Sarah Sherlock humorously suggests Harry looks perplexed in recent photos, as if unsure of his marital status. Scott adds a more serious note, pondering whether Harry is becoming aware of his predicament but feels trapped. Claudia expresses a hopeful tone, cheering for Harry's apparent awakening. Pia Zen compares a photo of the couple to Dumb and Dumber, while Susan reflects on whether Harry's realization might be too little, too late. These comments paint a picture of a public increasingly critical and weary of the couple's ongoing drama and public image. In this part of our discussion, Susan's comment stands out, suggesting Harry should stick with his nightmare of a wife and leave the public eye. Kay and Kay take a more humorous jab, likening Meghan's appearance in a photo to an unfortunate accident with an ugly tree. Elwyn offers a satirical take, calling Harry a ventriloquist's dummy puppet, a comment that sparks both amusement and reflection on Harry's perceived role in the relationship. Rocio adds a lighthearted observation about Meghan's expression in a photo, suggesting she looks uncomfortable. The topic of Harry's awareness and potential awakening continues with Cola's skeptical remark, "Harry will never wake from his coma." This is followed by Campbell's satirical suggestion about conducting a DNA test for the couple's children, implying skepticism about their existence. Teams 3345 expresses a more direct frustration, unable to stand the couple, while ET2 humorously imagines a scenario with President Harkle in the White House. Doria's comment takes a sharp turn, using a derogatory term to describe Meghan's character, reflecting a deep disdain for her. Aquarius points out inconsistencies in Meghan's past statements about her heritage, accusing her of opportunism and claiming Nigerian ancestry during the Invictus Games. The conversation then shifts to Harry's demeanor in public appearances. Elizabeth reacts with a series of emojis to a particular photo, conveying a mix of emotions. Pauline Ward and Kathleen speculate on Harry's state of mind, wondering if he's under the influence during public appearances. Sepia mentions a resemblance Meghan might have to a certain individual, though the name is unfamiliar, adding an element of intrigue to the ongoing discussion about Meghan's heritage and public persona. Wrapping up our discussion, Christine from Virginia shared laughing emojis, joining others in finding humor in the situation. St. Louis described a photo of the couple as a jump scare, reflecting the shock or surprise some feel towards their public appearances. Meldiah recalls Sugar's comment about the couple's happiness, yet notes the contradiction in a particular photo that portrayed them as horror and unhappy. This comment strikes a chord with the ongoing debate about the couple's genuine emotions. Rose Cole pointed out a spelling error in my previous comment, reminding me to be more attentive to language, even in a casual setting like YouTube. Meanwhile, Teresa and Shireem add their thoughts, with Teresa calling out Liz and Shireem seemingly tired of the ongoing discussions. Margaret brings a new perspective to Meghan's heritage, suggesting discrepancies in her reported percentages from different countries. This comment underscores the confusion and skepticism surrounding Meghan's identity claims. Lastly, Lauren's comment in French is acknowledged, though not understood, showing the diversity of our audience and the wide range of opinions on this topic. This lively discussion reflects a mix of humor, skepticism, and critique, showcasing the diverse opinions and reactions to Harry and Meghan's public life and image.